Hello dear student, today I am again here with another topic. The name of the topic is quality by design. It is also known as a QBD, okay? And we are commonly using this word in our pharmaceutical industry for the process development. So first we'll see what is QBD. It is a systematic approach to the development, so any type of the product development. If we take the tablet or the type of the product which we are developing in our pharmaceutical organization, so in this case we have to go for the systematic approach to development, to that particular development with the beginning with the predefined objective and emphasizing on the product and the process control. So we have to control the process as well as the product. So on what basis we are controlling this process and the product? We are controlling on the basis of the sound science and the quality risk management. So that's why we have to focus on the sound science. Whatever the thing which we are implementing under this quality by design, there should be some science behind it. Okay. And again, another thing is the quality risk. We have to manage this quality risk, or the risk assessment should be there, and that's why this quality by design is very important in pharmaceutical organization. But when we see this QBD, this is not a new concept, it is an old concept. So when we see this concept is first outlined by a very famous management guru known as Joseph Jurans. According to this Jurans, he supported that the quality could be planned. Okay, it could be planned if we go for a systematic approach. With the systematic approach, we could plan the quality of any product. Okay, so according to this Jurans according to the ICH guideline, if you see the ICH guideline Q8, in that also there is a mention of the quality by design, and under this Q8 guidelines of the ICH, the quality could be built into the product by design. Okay, so that's why this design, quality by design concept, is came into picture. Now let us have a look on this, the advantages of the QBD. There are various type of the advantages. When we talk about this QBD, the first important advantage is the better understanding of the process. Whatever the process which we are adopting in our pharmaceutical, we all know that we have to give input into this process and then we'll get the output. So what is input? Input may be the raw material. Process means the method which we are adopting, technology which we are adopting, and on the basis of this we are getting the output, that is a product. Okay, so there is a better understanding of the process. Second is the less batch failure, means the less number of the batch will be fail if we adopt this quality by design, and more efficient and effective control of the changes. Whatever the changes which takes place during the process is more effectively and efficiently controlled when we adopt the quality by design in our pharmaceuticals. Then there is the return on the investment. This is very important, and the cost saving is also taking place. Then another important advantage which we are getting is the reduction of the post-approval submission, and finally more efficient technology transfer we can carry out by adopting this quality by design approach. So dear, now you understand what is quality by design and what are the different advantages of QBD. Now let us have a look on the different key aspects of this QBD. There are different type of the key aspects. The first one is the target product profile. Second is the critical quality attributes. Third one is the risk assessment. This risk assessment comes under the Q9 of ICH guideline, design space, and last one is the control strategy. So first we'll see what is the target product profile. This target product profile is related with what? With the quality characteristic of the drug product which we are using, which we are producing. That identify with the achieve, or we can achieve that to more efficiently, that the desired quality having, or that particular product having the desired quality with the safety and the efficacy. Okay, so that's why this target product profile is very very important. So it is related with the product. Then second, once this target product profile is identified, the second important step is nothing but the critical quality attributes. So when we see the definition of this critical quality attributes, it is defined as a physical, chemical, biological or microbiological. So these are important properties or characteristics of that product, and that should be within the appropriate limit, range or the distribution, okay, to ensure the desired product quality. Okay, so that's why this critical quality attributes are also playing very important role, or it is another important key aspect of the quality by design. Then there is assessment, that is a Q9. It is a systematic process for what? For the assessment, control, contribution and the review of the risk, okay, to quality of the drug product. And here we'll find that it also comes under the Q9. Then another one is the design space. So under this design space, this is also the part of the ICH guideline. If you see the ICH guideline Q8R2, under this Q8R2 you'll find there is a description of the design space. Okay, so this ICH Q8R2 state that the design space is the multi-dimensional contribution and the interaction of the input variables. Input variables means the material attributes and the process parameter that have been demonstrating what? Demonstrating to provide assurance of the quality. So that's why this design space is also playing a very important key aspect under this quality by design. Then last one is the quality strategy. Quality strategy is defined as a plan set of what? Control design. Okay, and this is the strategy for from the current product. Okay, and we can control by applying this quality by design. So these are some important key aspect of the quality by design. Now friend, do you understand what is the key aspect of the QBD? Now we'll see how to achieve this quality by design. If you see the current status of any product or anything, suppose here, but by applying this quality by design, we can reach to this mountain at the top. That is the mountain of the knowledge, which required the different things, that is a PAT, RA and DOE. So what is PAT? That is the process analytical technology. Second one is the risk assessment. Third one is the design of the experiment. Okay, so we have to understand this thing also, that is the design of the experiment. So we have to design the experiment. Then the product quality and the performance. Another one which is important, that is achieve and assure by design of the effective and efficient manufacturing process. Then fourth one is the product specification based on the mechanistic understanding of how the formulation and the process factor impact product performance. And last one is the continuous assurance of the quality. That's why it is said that quality is the continuous process. Okay, that is the continuous assessment or continuous assurance of the quality is there. So dear friend, now you can easily understand how these are contributing.